For me, the key ingredients to my health is just to try and live in sync with nature holistically, organic whole foods, exercising, spending a lot of time in nature and observing nature, you know, climbing trees, swimming in rivers and working on myself as a human. It's always nice to discover something new. And the rope gave me that, you know. I can go for a hike and just take my rope and then get to a nice point. And it's kind of a meditation. You can do the meditation on the mountain, mindful and elegant, but you're also active and the body's learning, you know, it's learning something. The rope was first introduced to me by a man called David Weck, who's the founder of Weck Method. And I went over to California to learn it from him in person. He's quite a wild character. He's definitely got kind of an inventor's energy where they're just thinking kind of out there, but I saw his passion for it. Made me understand and see what it did biomechanically for the body. And that was just, it blew my mind. It really excited me and blew my mind. And I've just not really put it down since. The rope in itself isn't an invention, but the way he uses it, I think, is so unique. The beauty of the rope is that that is all you need. You don't actually need someone to teach you the rope, really. They can show you the patterns and kind of guide you to the understanding, but the teacher is the rope in itself. If your movement is not fluid or coordinated or well-timed, the rope will slap you, and that is like a little lesson. And so it's teaching the left and the right to work in unison at the same time, which without the rope completing that invisible connection, you don't have that feedback. So it's basically a feedback tool to show you how connected you are and to teach you how to be more connected. The sort of joy of the rope is it can match your mood. Some days you might want to be really gentle and just let it flow and let the rope pull you around. And then some days you want to get all animal and get aggressive, and you can just put it into the rope and you can feel the ripple come from the center of your body out to your hand and out the rope and whipping around. And it, when it slaps you, it shows you you're not moving coordinated. You need to time something slightly later or move the arm in this direction. And over time, repetition and revolutions of the rope, it just attenuates perfection and smooths the edges of your movement. If you see the way an animal moves, they never move one limb without something else rebalancing itself. They're constantly in a state of all joints, bones moving together. Now, most humans don't. We're kind of stiff. We wear shoes with thick soles. We walk with stiff backs, and we've got an animal body, like these animals that move and that use. The more joints you can utilize into any movement, the more efficient you are as a mover. If you can understand that, then you can start to grasp this. In a very short space of time, simply through putting in revolutions on the rope, the body learns to move as one unit more efficiently. Weck always called the rope your rite of passage, the rite of passage to your body. As you're moving on this figure of eight pattern, as you're following the infinity sign, it teaches you to move without a beginning or an end. The first two movements you learn on the rope, which are really super simple, are the underhand and the overhand. And within these two movements, all your joints in your upper body are moving on a figure of eight path. And in the underhand, this relates to locomotion, walking, running, sprinting, hitting sports, uppercut in boxing, tennis swing, golf swing, and that's on that one figure eight path. Now you reverse that path, reverse locomotion, you start to go in the overhand pattern, in the opposite direction, and this relates to boxing with a hook, throwing, swimming. And you start to recognize these patterns in all sports that we do, in all forms of movement. You will see either the underhand or the overhand pattern, coordination, and actually train your coordination and then go back to the sport that you love. You're going to move more efficiently and feel more grace within your body. People talk about the flow state, And I've never found something where you can find the flow state in a quicker time. And the rope really is the best tool I've come across by nothing else I've ever seen to help teach the body to move on that level of coordination. For me, it bridges that gap between meditation practice and movement. And I just haven't found anything that not only makes logical sense, but then in the practice of it is as effective a tool as the rope for all humans to just, it's so easy to pick up and learn the basics of it. And from there, it just gets better and smoother and more enjoyable. If you do it with the right intention, for anyone from an athlete to a yogi, a martial artist, someone who works a desk job to a teenager, it's so universal. And I believe it would benefit everyone.